Good afternoon on this lovely spring day. I was telling my wife on the way in, we just have not lucked out, but we really complain a lot, don't we? We had a drought almost without any rain, and now we're complaining that we don't have the sun. So I guess we can't win. The only thing we all agree on is we don't want any snow, and especially this winter. Thank you so much for coming here. This is a historic occasion because, again, we take this arsenal and we take it to its next step in our history, as well as the future, which will be the history of tomorrow. And we're very thankful that all of you have come. I'm very happy to have here with us Rex Metcalf. We have Al Kachak and John Carrar, our historian. We're happy to have Jerry Kessler from Friends of the Long Island Heritage. And we're very, very honored to have Robert Hughes, our historian. So the crew's here. Everyone is here that's had anything to do with this, that really has a love for this facility. This is an interesting facility. Today we're marking the completion of the restoration of the only known colonial arsenal still standing on Long Island. The original portion of the structure was built around 1740 and originally used for the storage of grain. After the land was sold, it was converted to a residence in 1748. It was sold again to Job Samus, who was a weaver who lived there for 41 years and who expanded it in 1765 to include a small north chamber. And you can see as you enter from the back, that's the chamber that was added. The second story garret accessed by a lattice there from the fire room until 1776 and subsequently from the north chamber was probably used for storage. It was the garret that Job Samus probably used when he agreed to store powder, muskets, and other military stores for the Suffolk County Militia beginning in 1775. The militia, drawn primarily from Huntington residents, drilled regularly on the adjacent village green. And, by historic rights, the militia is our ceremonial militia. Now notice, it was Suffolk County, but mainly people from Huntington. And I am the ceremonial colonel, which is the head of the militia. The general was General George Washington, and that remains for him, that designation. But I guess we'll have to tell Steve Ballone that I am head of the militia for Suffolk County. And Mark Hutherson will remind him. When repairs were made to the house in 1930, a small cache of colonial muskets were found under the original floorboards, most likely hidden by Samus prior to the British occupation of Huntington on September 1st, 1776, after the disastrous colonial defeat at the Battle of Long Island on August 27, 1776. In 1974, in anticipation of the nation's bicentennial, the town of Huntington acquired the arsenal. The town restored the front half of the building in the 1970s, while the back half continued to be used as a residence until 1986. By 2000, the cedar shingle roof was badly deteriorated. In addition, it was decided that the back half of the building should be restored by removing modern building elements to uncover surviving 18th century fabric and the replacement of missing elements. The restoration project was funded by the town, including some of our open space funds dollars, and a $49,300 historic preservation grant from the New York State Office of Parks, Recreation, and Historic Preservation. A total project budget of $179,000. The original grant proposal was put together by Rex Metcalf and Al and Sheila Kachak. Al is here. Sheila is no longer with us. And today, of course, we'll be doing this as well in her honor. Unfortunately, she passed away, I think it was 2 years ago, so she hasn't seen the project complete. The grant application was completed by John Carrar. The project carefully restored the building to its colonial-era condition, exposing the original frame timbers, ceiling beams, ceiling boards, and floorboards. Also original to the building are the back door into the lean-to section of the building and the box lock mounted on the front door exterior. Full restoration of the building provides a more complete interpretation of the building. The work also provides ADA compliant access to this building. The arsenal will be open by appointment for tours conducted by militia volunteers. The volunteers will provide visitors with an explanation of the many original colonial artifacts on display, including typical household furnishings, spinning and weaving equipment, and military equipment. And when you have a chance to go inside and visit, you'll see that equipment on display. And I mentioned to my wife, who was here, that there's a large loom there that she should become familiar with. As in colonial times, where are you, Pat? She's laughing at me. As in colonial times, the arsenal is also the mustering site for the Huntington Militia, the contemporary members of which are the official ceremonial honor guard of the town of Huntington and regularly participate in colonial era encampments and other historical reenactments on the adjacent village green, as well as other sites in the region. This dedication is being held in conjunction with the militia's muster day, which will continue after this dedication. At this point, it gives me pleasure to introduce to you Councilman Mark Cuthbertson.
Thank you, Mr. Supervisor. Just such an interesting history of this building in our town that no matter how many years I've been in this office, I'm always learning something new, so that was great. Thank you all for being here on this historic day for the town. It's great to see an important community and cultural asset preserved with the hard work of people who care about the great history of our town. Councilwoman Berland.
I want to welcome you all here today. Thank you for participating in this ceremony. The militia does such wonderful enactments. And, you know, I was talking to someone before we started. You know, my kids, I have four kids, and the youngest is now 15. When they were little, like your kids' age, we would come here all the time and watch the enactments, and it's just so exciting to, you know, to watch what they do and to hear the history and to participate in it and get an opportunity, maybe if you're nice, to like try to fire off one of the little wooden guns there. So I know Dad did. I don't know. I mean, I think the kids get an opportunity too to try. So, but thank you all for being here. It's a wonderful event. We have fantastic history in our town, and it's great that we could be a part of a town that celebrates that and make sure it goes on for generations to come. Thank you, Mr. Supervisor. Let me introduce to you Mark Mayoka.
Thank you. I want to thank Colonel Petrone for giving us a great background on this program. And it's tough to envision that I think in the early 1770s that the Huntington Militia actually was out there practicing on the village green, and that I want to thank everyone for their involvement in preserving and protecting one of our important historic buildings in the town's arsenal. And this is what Huntington is all about, preserving and protecting our past, and so that we have it available for future generations. And I want to thank you all for coming. Thank you.
Thanks, Mark.
At this point, I'd like to call on Robert Ambrose, our commander, who would like to say a few words. Commander of our militia.
Good day to you all. Welcome. As has been said, the arsenal has been the home and headquarters of the Huntington Militia since the 18th century, and it remains so today. On behalf of the militia, I would like to say that we very much appreciate all of the work and the restoration that has gone on. Arsenal had been falling into a bit of disrepair, and we were very saddened to see that it might not last beyond this generation. And we're very, very happy to learn when the grants were received that a new restoration project would begin, and that the original arsenal would be restored to as it was in 1775. And I'm pretty certain that if Joe Samus were walking down the road and came up the path to his front door and walked inside, he very much would feel at home again. I want to thank Al Katchik and Rex Metcalf for doing a great deal of the work on the interior, doing the furnishing and making sure that everything looks just as it would in the 18th century. I thank you all for coming, and I welcome you to any of our events, and please do come to Huntington Independence Day in July, as we will be doing a great big reenactment of the day the Declaration of Independence arrived in Huntington. I thank you all.
Thank you. Also, it should be noted that Jerry Kessler from our Friends of Long Island Heritage, Jerry, was very, very involved and actually wrote the supporting grant letters so that we could get this. And the Heritage, the Friends of the Heritage, is well respected by the state and in all the historic communities. And so we thank you very much for helping to make this possible. Ladies and gentlemen, now on behalf of the town board and the people of the town of Huntington, I hereby rededicate the arsenal in its present stage, and we will rededicate this now, and then at the same time I charge the militia with the guardianship of this as the colonel and as the town supervisor. You have guardianship once again of this new restored facility, and thank you for the work that you've been doing as we formally dedicate this to the people of the town of Huntington. Thank you.
Make ready! Freeze it! Fire!
Look at the cannon, too. All right.
There we go. Thank you. Have a great day.